first came here, it was so exciting because I've heard so much from my brothers and my dad and my uncles, and I came here to experience it, and it was great. It was like a sleepover every night.
I decided to come to Glenstal because I only live 20 minutes away, and I was originally meant to be going to another school, but my parents went to the open days and they saw the facilities and they thought they were amazing.
I chose Glenstal because I had four brothers who came here, one still here in sixth year. It's a good place to go.
My dad is Austrian and my mum is Irish, and I have three brothers. I heard about Glenstal through my mother, so I went on the taster days and I loved it. It was great fun.
I didn't actually know that much about Glenstal, but when I came for the live-in in fifth class, I just thought it was amazing, and I spoke to my mom about it, and I suppose we both decided that it was the place I wanted to go, and I'm happy with my decision that I've stayed here.
My parents had never really told me I was going to boarding school until I was in fifth or sixth class, when I went to the live-in here in Glenstal, and that was when I was first introduced to Glenstal properly. It was a very interesting experience being here. I enjoyed it a lot. Then I had accepted after the live-in that I was coming to boarding school for 6 years anyway.
Day boarding is much different to boarding, but it's good to do just to settle into the school if you're a bit nervous to come in.
I'm from County Louth myself, so my house is about 2 hours and 40 minutes away from here. So when I came here first, I was quite intimidated to be living so far away from home, but I found that so many other boys are in the exact same boat, and because of that we were able to help each other and to settle in, and the school helped us as well. It's like one big family here at Glenstal.
When my parents left on the first day, I instantly felt homesick, and it was quite difficult for the first half of first year, and it was hard balancing school and being homesick, as I was trying to do well at school and I was also trying to take my mind off home the entire time. So I found it quite difficult for the first half of first year.
When I came here, there wasn't really any time to be lonely because you're so busy all the time and you're kind of tired at night.
So I didn't really feel homesick at all, but a lot of the boys did, and so I suppose I kind of felt as though one of my roles was to help the other boys through it.
At the beginning I wasn't very homesick, but when I came back from my family in after Christmas, I felt very homesick since I'd spent a lot of time with them. I dealt with it mainly by sport and hanging out with my friends.
When I came here first, all the prefects were brilliant. They told me to just, everything would be fine in a few months. Like, it was all brand new to me. Everyone in our year is feeling the same thing. It was a new experience, but a few months on, we're all very comfortable and we all really like it here.
Because the school is so small and you get to know everybody and learn their names, unlike in most other schools. So there's lots of friendships being developed and there's no sense of you don't know who someone is. It's quite easy to go up to anyone and talk to them.
If you didn't understand where you were meant to go and you accidentally break a rule, they'll understand and they'll help you, especially the teachers. Some of them are great, especially if you bring the wrong books or you don't know where to go and you're late, then they'll understand.
When I first came here, the dorms were and the shower facilities were a small bit decrepit, but since then most of them have been renovated. The younger years now enjoy far better facilities than I did in my time.
The look of the accommodation was great because you were all together with your friends every night, and some nights you'd be up a lot, but others it'd be great because everyone just fell asleep, so tired from everything that day. The food is good because it's obviously not like home, but it's still edible and it's pretty nice.
The accommodation, it's very good. It's pretty handy. You have a good bit of space for your clothes and you have a good bed. It's not bad. And you can bring your own tuck. There's lockers to keep your tuck in. Junior house and inter house have their own pantry. You have a kettle, a microwave, a sink and more. In senior house you have a George Foreman, so you can cook toasties on it. You have your own fridge and it's pretty handy.
The new school building, it's a wonderful learning environment. You're so close to nature with the trees close to the windows. The small classrooms for small class numbers really gives you a great opportunity to learn and to to absorb as much as you can, and that's primarily why I came here.
Academically, I'm not the best, but I mean, you can get good help. There's a resource centre, so if you don't do Irish, and even if you do all the subjects, there's always time. They'll always get you at one point in the classes, or some point if you're having any problem, there's always a teacher there that can help you.
Well, Glenstal prides itself on its academic standards, and this was manifest from the beginning, really, when I arrived. The teachers had a good, strong relationship, and they were really able to give individual care and attention to each student, and that made it very easy.
I think Glenstal is amazing for sports. I personally had never played rugby before I came to Glenstal, and we were all encouraged to play rugby in first year, so I thought I'd give it a shot, why not? I think it's amazing how the whole school just comes together in regards to sports as well. Like for the junior and senior cup matches, the whole school goes out and we put face paint on our faces and we bring signs and logos and flags. And
I find the sports great, as you every single day of the week you can do something. You can go play rugby with your friends in the winter, and then you can go play tennis and soccer in the summer. I love going to the sports hall and messing around with the rugby ball with my friends.
If I had a problem, I'd probably go to my friends first and see what they think. And then if I couldn't get an answer, then I'd go to maybe my housemaster and sometimes the matron, the nurse, and that would probably sort it out.
If I ever have a problem with someone bullying me or anything, you can go to a housemaster or one of the monks and sort it out very calmly. You know, the bully would never get in huge trouble. You know, it'd be dealt with.
It's a real change from primary school, because when you're in sixth class, you're sort of at the top of the school. But it's a very new experience when you come into a new school.
Very easy to keep in touch with your parents. I mean, you know, there's breaks where you can call them at night, you can call them, and, you know, with your friends at home, you know, these days it's fairly easy to keep in touch with them. I mean, I still have all my friends at home.
A lot of interaction within school and outside of the school. So it's hard not to interact with everyone. Especially with housemasters that can be monks as well, so you do get a taste of all different kinds of life here.
Because my parents are so far away, there's always something to do with the weekends instead of just staying inside. Sometimes we go to the cinema, other times we will go kayaking.
If I don't go home, my parents would usually collect me on a Sunday to bring me out for lunch, which is brilliant. Some boys in my year live very far away, some even live abroad. So we might bring them out for lunch as well, or take them home for the weekend.
Because I live so close, I tend to go out most Sundays after Mass, as I'm in the choir, so I have a commitment to stay. Some boys I know, like my friends who live abroad or live too far away, stay in almost every weekend, bar long weekends.
Most of the foreign students who come here have excellent English, and we're used to having foreign students in the schools. They become very well integrated very quickly. I don't think it's any sort of problem at all. Once you get past the initial language and cultural differences, I mean they're very similar. They're just young boys like ourselves.
In my time at Glenstal, I've gone to Italy for a ski trip in second year, and I've gone to Finland as well on a drama trip, and I went to Australia as well. And in 2 days' time, I'm going to Greece, to Athens, for the classics trip. So it's amazing.
We recently went on a school trip to Italy for skiing with the whole year. The food was lovely and so was the accommodation. And we were right on top of the mountain, so we could get up and get skiing as soon as possible.
In fourth year, you also have the option of going to Australia, which is cool. You can also go to America as well if you're not a fan of Australia. And everyone kind of loves those kind of trips. You go for about a month or two, and you know, no one's ever complained about them. They're one of the best trips you can go on.
This summer, I'm hoping to go to Kenya with six other lads, and we're going to go and help an orphanage there and a school. And I'm looking forward to bringing the Glenstal ethos to the school and helping them in any way we can.
Music is something that's very much valued, and anyone who likes to get involved with it, they're really encouraged to do so. The students are given a lot of opportunities to perform in front of the school and the staff alike and their parents.
I've always partaken in the Battle of the Bands each year, and we've always done pretty well coming out with prizes. And I've done the school show as well. We did Back to the 80s this year. That was good fun.
One subject I'm quite good at is music. I play the piano and sing. I had my music practicals earlier on in the year. I felt I did quite well in it. It's a pretty handy place to do music because they have so many choices. You could do trombone, piano, violin, cello, bass, etc. You know, it's a very good place to do everything you want.
To most boys here, having no girls is quite different when they first arrive in first year, but by sixth year I think everyone kind of has gotten over it.
I think that for the main part there isn't that much of an issue because boys do go out on the weekends and they get to see their friends or whatever.
It is possible obviously to have communication with other girls from other schools as we all have friends and stuff, so it's not impossible. So we're not 100% blocked out from the rest of the world.
Well, now that my time has come to leave Glenstal, I'm quite sad about it, to be honest, because I've lived here for six years and it's become like a second home to me. But I think the school has given me the skills that I need to move on, and I'm very grateful for that.